Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a mist filter. Now, generally speaking, you would use a mist filter in your iPhone or smartphone for mobile filmmaking to help diffuse the overall uber sharp look that modern mobile devices give you, if that makes sense. And the problem with using an actual mist filter in front of the likes of an ND filter at the filming end is that you're baking in the effect. You can't obviously counteract it if you don't like the effect. So what I'm going to show you in LumaFusion today is how to create a mist filter effect, and then that way, if you really want to soften down the overall harshness of digital video, then you can do it in post-production and choose to what strength you want to play it to rather than baking it in at the actual recording end of things. So let's get started. So I've got a couple examples for you. I've got a young lady holding a pencil, deep in thought, and then I've got another young lady deciding on cash by the looks of it or Bitcoin. But what we've got here is natural daylight and artificial light. That's the main reasons why I've chosen these two stock clips. The first thing you're going to want to do is copy the clips. So if you're using the keyboard shortcut Command D, I might as well just do it to the second one at the same time. You're then going to go to your top clip, and you're going to want to go into number 5, which is color and effects. Then you're going to tap on original. Now, the thing about mist filters is that it tends to suck out a bit of the contrast, and then it gets reapplied, at least in post, by the soft light blend. So what you want to do is just dial back all the contrast using an original preset so it looks quite flat. And then from there, we're going to change the blending mode to soft light. And you'll see that instantly gives you much more contrast without even doing anything else. But we've got one more thing to do to just sweeten up this whole misting effect. And for that, we need to go back to our color and effects, go to our blur section. Now, the obvious thing here would be to use a Gaussian blur. But the problem with using Gaussian blur is that it's more of a soft focus effect. So if you want a dreamy, soft focus look to your video, for example, if I tap here or here or here, then Gaussian blur is where you want to be. But for a mist effect, I actually want to use a box blur. And I'm going to go for middle box blur 40. And of course, you can play with the strength. And because you've already applied the blending mode, you can see in real time what's going on. Now I'm just going to reset that to 40. That's a good point to be at. Now that we're back in frame and fit and down in blending, you can then decide how strong you want the mist effect to actually be. Obviously, zero opacity, no overall effect, and then you can just gradually bring it back up and decide how much of a mist effect you want it to be. I quite like it quite strong. And then if we play through, you can see what's going on. And this is not part of the actual tutorial in the sense of you don't need to do this, but I'll just show you a split screen of what's going on. So if we actually take it back to about here, and then play it back at the beginning, you can see the difference in the skin tone, the color of the eyes, and the overall contrast value compared to the layer below. So we'll just reset that. That's it. It's as simple as that. There's the effect again. I'll switch it off here. And then back on. That's what it looks like in a sort of natural light. We'll take a look at it now in artificial light. Maybe by the time we finish this little clip, the girl will have decided whether she wants to buy Bitcoin or keep her cash. Again, go to number 5 on the keyboard if you're using a keyboard. Tap on original, reduce all contrast, make it as flat as possible. And at this point, we go back to number 1, change the blending to soft light. And you'll see it deepens the contrast automatically. Then go to number 5, back to our blurs. Just scroll down till you get to blocks blur. Go for 40 in the middle, and that's sure you're pretty much done. Then press number 1 on the keyboard, back to frame and fit, and then you can decide on how much effect you want to actually use. The good thing about mist filters, especially when it comes to artificial light, is it helps break up and diffuse hard light. So a mist filter is something that you definitely want to use. A, if you're in natural light, if it's like a midday sun scenario, mist filter is definitely going to be a good friend to you. In an artificial light, a hard light, which you can see behind the young woman's head and obviously the bare bulb at the bottom corner of the screen. And again, I quite like quite a lot of mist And that's it done. So we'll just go back to the beginning. There's the overall effect. And there's the daylight version and then the artificial light version. And there you go. That's it. Simple as that. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If I've earned your subscription today, subscribe. Tick the little bell to get the notifications for the next video tutorial. And I will catch you on the next one. See you later.